Today's video is about sugar. The idea was to start a series on weight loss tips, and I thought I should start with sugar first because everyone likes sugar, and there's a reason for it, because we are evolutionarily programmed to look for sweet stuff, because sweet stuff is where most of the calories come from. And in our past we used to have a shortage of calories, and because in order to overcome that shortage of calories, our bodies would be designed to take as much calories as possible when it's available. And the sweet calories, the sweet foods usually contain a large amount of calories, and those sweet foods allowed us to deposit more fat when we got those calories. So there's a reason why we like sugar. Now, when I'm talking about sugar, I'm talking about table sugar mainly, and table sugar is a combination of glucose and fructose. And glucose on its own is not a huge problem, but fructose is where most of the trouble comes when it comes to metabolism. So the calories in glucose is what mainly causes us to gain weight, but in fructose the effect is disproportionate. The effect is metabolic. So fructose has effects on the metabolism that then amplifies the effect of all the other calories that you consume. So fructose makes it easier for your body to deposit fat. The signal that fructose gives to your body is to deposit fat. And so even if you're taking a tiny amount of fructose, it is then going to cause the other calories in your diet to have a higher chance of turning into fat. So that is why fructose is a problem. So you might be taking a really small quantity, but that small quantity is enough to create trouble. So what it does is it depletes the liver of phosphorus, and the phosphorus comes from ATP, which is the energy currency of the body. And when the phosphorus is removed from ATP, it turns into ADP, and the liver starts to run out of energy. The liver cells don't have enough energy to run their metabolic processes. So now the liver does the next best thing. Whatever calories it's got, because it's not able to process it, in order to process calories, it needs the ATP. And because there's a shortage of ATP within the liver cells, it starts to convert the calories that it's getting into fat as a temporary storage mechanism. So that is how it deposits fat. Now, the drop in ATP within the cells also causes the cells to start increasing uric acid production, and that cycle of increasing uric acid production has further problems that create down the metabolic pathways. Triglycerides go up. So the sources of sugar and fructose in your diet is mainly sugar. Now, if you're stopping sugar and you're going on to an alternative like jaggery or honey, there's still fructose in it, so you're still going to get the same effects. The difference is that it's going to be a very minor difference, because the fructose is still there, and especially in honey. Honey is 100% fructose, almost entirely fructose. So you might be thinking that honey is a safer alternative, but honey is, if you use it on a daily basis, you are only going to end up getting more and more metabolically unwell. And the same thing with jaggery. So jaggery is less refined. Doesn't mean it doesn't have fructose. It will create the same problems, just that there's less fructose because it's less dense. It's less refined. But the problem is, you're not going to feel the food as sweet as it was when you used sugar or honey. And so you're going to add more of it. So ultimately, if you're going to aim for the same sweetness, you're going to end up with the same metabolic problems. Processed foods, so things that come in packets, are usually have added sugar. So you won't see sugar visibly. You won't see sugar in that food, but sugar's been added. You might not even taste it, but the flavor, the ultimate flavor of that food is produced by adding sugar. So when you get processed food, if at all you take processed food, have a look at the ingredients and you'll see that there is sugar in there. And then you need to make sure that you're not over consuming those processed foods. ideally you shouldn't be consuming processed foods. Now, fruit juices are another big source of fructose and sugar. So again, there's this idea that fruit juices are healthy. They are not. Fruits are meant to be chewed and eaten, and if you're juicing it, you're going to be able to consume more fruits than you would. So you might be able to eat one apple, which is already putting you at a higher at the higher limit of fructose consumption. But one apple juiced is not going to, not going to satisfy you. You're going to need three or four apples juiced if you need to have a big glass of apple juice. So that basically you're then going to eat three or four apples, and you're going to eat it in the sense you're going to drink it in a few minutes. Now imagine how long it would take you to chew four apples. And imagine how difficult it would be to chew four apples. But juicing it and drinking it takes only a few minutes. And that is where the problem comes. Now, so fruit juices are a bad idea. You shouldn't be drinking fruits. You should be chewing and eating it. And if you're somebody who's trying to lose weight, if you're somebody who's trying to lose fat, you can have fruit. It's just that you need to make sure that the calories you're consuming are not going over the limit. So if you're counting calories, you need to account for the fruit too. And if you must, so my patients, when I advise them on how to lose weight, I ask them to limit themselves to one fruit a day. And if at all you must have fruit, try and go for the less ripe ones, go for the more tart ones, so that there's less fructose in it. Now, if you ask me for what alternatives there are to sugar, I'm going to give you a very disappointing answer. I'm going to say there's no real healthy alternative to sugar. You're just going to have to cut back. And if you're really serious about getting healthy, you're going to have to get rid of the sugar from your diet. If you're serious about losing weight, so you're going through all this trouble, you're cutting calories, you're exercising, you're trying to be healthy, and then you have 2 teaspoons of sugar in your tea and coffee twice a day, and half of that hard work is wiped out because the fructose in there is helping your body to hold on to more and more fat. So, with regards to fruit, you need to limit the intake if you are seriously trying to lose weight. I'm not asking you to go off it. Fruits that are predominantly glucose. So some types of banana are predominantly glucose. I don't have the list in front of me. Now, the same thing goes with vegetables. Now, the carrots and potatoes and beetroot tend to get a bad rap when it comes to losing weight, but they're actually quite healthy because they contain a lot of fiber, and the starch, the carbohydrate in these vegetables are mostly glucose. So they don't cause as much fat gain as fruits or fruit juices do or sugar does. So vegetables, more vegetables, less of those sweet fruit, no fruit juices, avoid sugar. So that's about today's video on sugar. If you've got questions, please post them in the comments. Thank you.